Welcome back, everybody, here to ESWC Qualifiers Final, where we are here trying to work out who gets to represent the East, MUFC or Willoughby Orange. We've already got one game in, lasting for over 70 minutes long. And, well, at the end of the day, it does put MUFC one game up over Orange. It is an all-Malaysian final. Let's jump ourselves inside the game, because as you guys would have heard, who tuned on the live stream, Radiant Team were banning. Oh, yes. Hey, take out a couple. We always jump in just a little bit later into the draft. That way, hey, we get to chill. We get to, like, mull over what's already happened. Once again, Naga plus Templar Assassin, both being banned out by HYHY, who is the standard and is actually HYHY for those people out there who are still discussing that it's not. He is merely just standing in for this game. Sharky, Ken, Net, and Ohio is his name. That'll be the last player in for MUFC. Prophet as well as Lycan being banned out this time by Orange, so they believe the Lycan is worth the ban. It was powerful for HYHY in the last game, even though it was weak on the lanes. And it was kind of more of a that timing thing. We saw it yesterday with Broodmother, where you just lose that potential of what Broodmother's able to achieve. And during the team fights, Broodmother got to the point where she was useless. There's too much pressure put on the Queen of Pain, which was why when we saw Orange try and go in for the Roshan, which really they didn't prepare for well enough. And then MUFC was so easy to able to just to come down. They found Queen of Pain, singing Half-Life, and was just like, sweet, freebie, take it. And then the pressure was just way too much happening onto the Queen of Pain. So they got distributed a little bit better in this game. Darkseer and Tidehunter, so even by distributing it, they're going to get themselves a huge amount of copy. The Darkseer, such a brutal hero, especially with Darkseer and Tidehunter being used in combination. Now all we need is just a nice little AoE stun. Get that, get the CK Lina maybe coming up as well to give them a nice strong lane. They got to look towards the middle lane at the same time. TA has already been banned out, so they won't be going that. But Invoker will be the option. It's going to be careful about the Deafening Blast. Or we could also go down the lines of Thrall, so Disruptor could be happening as well. It'll be a nice little wall to come off. Darkseer to pull them all in. Everyone gets trapped. Everyone gets silenced in the ultimate. It's a pretty harsh combo to try and deal with. Or the combo which we saw coming out yesterday came out from, I believe it was EG. Misery was playing on the Earthshaker in that game. And who was it? It was Demon on the Darkseer, Misery on the Earthshaker. And it's just this easy pull into an Echo Slam. It's like the easiest setup of your life. And the best Echo Slam of your life. So much damage. So much damage with it. Lashrak gets picked this time around. Everybody puts their hands up for Lashrak. A lovely second pick. HYHY, you got to get a third pick in too. I love that too, that MUFC bring HYHY in as a stand-in. He's like, yeah, I'll draft. Oh, okay. Yeah. There's that CK going to be picked up instead by HYHY. So strong laning from both, all three of these guys. In fact, you could be looking at an aggressive tri-lane right here. Chaos Knight and Lashrak, good duels they can go just by themselves. But if you can combine that with the Rubick, so Rubick also having to pick up control, and then the negative damage, which means CK can get in close and not risk too much damage. Just a little bit of damage, but not too much damage. So it's an okay combination. That also allows Rubick to go solo mid, so if they need to run that extra hero up on that top lane, or if they do need to pick themselves up another core hero and put Rubick into support, that's an option as well. But Orange, if they're gonna group around team fight. Do they even just say, you know what, Tidehunter, we're going to attempt him on the off lane? Do we really want to run Tide anywhere near CK as well as the track? Chen will be the pickup from Orange. Someone gets attacked, maybe you can pull them out, but judging by Chaos Knight and Lashrak, you got a lot of stun lockdown time, but it's also some really quick damage that comes out from them, and the Chen pullback won't be enough in the early levels.
Orange's turn to ban.
Lone Druid will be the next ban. So we go into our next ban stage. Obviously, guys, if you look at the middle line, it's completely stuffed up as far as our convention goes, as who's picking, who's banning. Because in this scenario, it does say that we've got ourselves the three bans, which is not the case anymore. We go with two bans, three picks, three bans, two picks. That's the way the captain's draft works ever since the changes that happened and 7.5. Well, 6.75. Yeah, that doesn't work. 6.75. Oh. I apologize. Slightly sleep deprived again. It was actually my own fault as well, so I ask for no sympathy. Just understanding. So, Anti-Mage and Wisp. It's being banned out by Orange. Surprising they still wanted to ban out the Wisp. Looking at another support hero. I suppose with CK and Lechrank, you do have enough control in the lane with just those guys. But normally when we see teams running a Wisp, as that support Wisp, you need to give the Wisp a lot of space. And normally you try and make it so it's a dual lane that happens with Lechrank and Chaos Knight. With just CK plus the Wisp, that way they can both get up to level 6 around the same time. Then we can see ganking around the place. 5 seconds remaining. And Queen of Pain now going to be banned out here by Orange. Radiant, so they're starting to look towards mid lane. They already assume the off lane, so they can't ban against it. You can't ban all the off lane heroes as well. So the best way you can go about it, let's just look towards the middle lane, take out the combination we fear with the Chaos Knight, that big global control, Invoker being banned out as well, so a lot of the big mid lane heroes are already being taken out. And HYHY is happy with this, he's already got his Rubick pickup, so he doesn't really care too much. While Rubick's in the pool, he doesn't have to worry. And now the last ban out from Orange. Will it be another mid-focus kind of hero, or do we look to something else? We won't even look towards jungle. Enigma hasn't been picked up just yet, and he was our final ban last game. He might be the final ban again this time around. 10 seconds. By the way, guys, if you are tuning in through Dota TV, hi. If you're tuning in through the live stream, hello even more to you guys. I love people on the live stream. Dota TV's good. But I love it when people join us on the live stream. There's our Windrunner ban. So they ban the offlaner. They ban the escaping offlaner. The bounty hunter is still available as well. And it just would cause a little bit too much melee. Actually, it's not too bad. It's not too bad. You still got the stun. Problem is when bounty hunter gets pulled into the middle of a Darkseer wall, you know he's going to die very, very quickly. So you need someone else that can survive on the offlane. We kind of nice if you had yourself a Puck. Someone that can offer a semi amount of silence or control during this team fight. Instead of just trying to tank it like a boss. And there's some control during the team fight. So you can see BKB ultimate. Number two, if SF gets pulled into that Darkseer ultimate and then dies, he'll expend half of his souls. So the normal souls he loses, SF, he's the guy with the buff, he goes down. But does this mean we get to see HYHY playing Shadow Fiend? Hell frickin' yeah. I'll take that any day. Orange, they're going to get their pickup, so they see SF. And they can start to worry a little bit out about it. Maybe we might even see a different kind of pick. Yeah, people are talking about Morphling, but Morphling you probably won't see anymore because the ability to interrupt him so easily. Tinker pick, so Orange going to go split push. It might force HYHY to grab Nature's Prophet as his final one. Oh no, wait, he's already banned out. Oh, how are you supposed to split push against that? You can't. In fact, that's really the weakness of this lineup that's coming out from MUFC. It's just the fact that if you look at the lineup, there's just no great split push. There's great team fight potential, and there's good ganking potential, and good like strength ability just to stand and just keep on going. Reserve time. But that one thing they're lacking is going to be the ability to fight as and Enigma will be their final one. It's still the split push that is their problem. And also, they're offlaners now. It's going to force them to run an aggressive tri-lane. Or at least the dual lane of Chaos Knight as well as Lechrank on top lane, which won't actually be too bad. Both Chen and Tidehunter, to a point, can cause a little bit of trouble up there. But only in the later levels. Chen grabs one creep, and that's all he'll have to run with. But you've got Chaos Knight and Lechrank, both with good setup stuns and good control. They'll leave SF to farm up safely on that bottom lane up against the Darkseer. So doing that from range is going to be difficult to start with because of the Iron Shell. Getting the right timing with the base damage which Shadow Fiend has. But once he starts storing up a couple more souls, then he's going to be looking a lot better. And Rubik, well, he can run offlane, but not normally in this scenario. Rubik offlane only ever works when you're running with a dire side and you can pull the ancient stack. For guys also asking for Magnetor, he's not part of the Captain's Mode. That's the reason why. People are calling out for Tiny and Batrider. Morphling is still going to be the pickup from Orange. They're still going to go with it. Morphling got himself a little bit nerfed. Let me just bring up the changeling. So I was referring to this all day yesterday. So where's my Morphling? So yeah, cast animation time, it was increased by a little bit too. So you can't always get that quick boom and boom. Also, you've got the change in the waveform. So waveform no longer allows you to start attacking or casting before it's completed. So that big shotgun combo is a lot more delayed now because the casting time's increased. You can't just waveform and TP at the same time or do these hits as you fly on through. So it's not this instant boom kind of damage that happens. And that kind of timing is more than enough time for CK, Lashrak, Rubik, or even Enigma to get that Malivus stun off. Get that kind of controlling stun out on top of the Morphling. And this could be a decent problem for Orange. There's also the difference too. The Morph mana cost has been increased by 30 mana. It's not much, but it's a decent amount when you don't really have a high mana pool to start with. Like you get 221 mana pool, and it costs you 30 mana per second when you morph. And that kind of mana cost when you're trying to also make sure you can waveform as well as adaptive strike, there's a lot to pull out. And of course your base damage has been increased by 6, so that's the only upside for him. And we're going to see a safe build here for Yamata, heading towards the top lane. Ice. He is taking on that Darkseer and heading a little bit closer towards mid lane, but Tinker will be there. KOXO will take up that role. So Winter and Extinct, the Tide as well as Chen to support in the top lane. And it will be Ice. Judging by his build, it's quite possible he could be looking at a jungle Darkseer, which is kind of crazy. He should be on the bot lane. Up towards the top lane. Looks like Ken will be running the offlane Enigma. Puts our middle lane. HY, the boss. So he will be taking up the Shadow Fiend role in the middle lane. And then over towards our bottom lane. We got Ohio. He'll be the Chaos Knight in this game. Net. Lashrak support, Sharky also supporting on the Rubik. Leaving a couple of sentry wards here on the bottom lane. Leaving it mainly with Net. So they realize that no one's going to be down here. And this could be the problem now for MUFC's laning. That's why I thought they're going to run aggressive tri-lane to start with. To see if they could shut down the level of farm that'll be happening on the top lane. Because Enigma, denying's okay. That's kind of cool. But unless they can really gank and kill off this Darkseer, it's just not going to be worth it. And they're already looking for that first rune. It's going to spawn top. Invis rune for Winter. Couldn't have been better for him. He's trying to keep it secret. May as well take it. Head up towards the top lane. Just keep Enigma away from the lane. Enigma will never walk past this line. If he does, he's dead. It's basically as simple as that. Enigma has no escape mechanism. He's just a denial on that top lane. For guys who, for people who ask the question about who won the first game and stuff like that, look for the pips at the top of the screen, just under the kill count, and you'll find out. All the time. We'll always turn that on for any game we're running. Even if it is like a best of one, we can even turn it on then. Net looking to keep a lot of space in that bottom lane. Ice, the first thing he levels up is Surge. Gonna have to run the off lane. Oh, the easiest thing in the world. And looks like Sharky's going to help out this middle lane too. Try and protect HYHY until he gets... It's not even the levels, it's till he gets souls. Souls are the most important thing for HYHY to gather. Already up at, well, he's got 4 hits. Now 6. 4 of them denies, 2 of them legitimate farming hits. Yamata trying to be as aggressive as he can on this top lane. Well, Enigma... able to get some easy levels behind the tower. This is just a lack of control which is happening now. And this is the reason why Winter was double stacking this camp. KYXY. Just gotta watch his farm and just see what his build's going to. We've seen some Tinkers not even going BTs directly first, getting that Sol Ring. So with the Sol Ring, able to spam off at least a couple of abilities to hold the towers, but only when you're under significant pressure. If at any point you can just buy up your BTs, you want to do that as early as you possibly can. Net's going to look for Ryze. There's a 2-minute rune. And up, Net, Edict, steals the Illusion Rune too. And Ice is completely forced away. Any kind of damage that Net is capable of doing to Ice, he's quite happy to inflict it. Make Ice use a consumable. He's down to one salve and one tango charge left. And Chaos Knight in the meantime gets free farm in the bottom lane. But at the same time, Morphling's having a good time on the top lane. 15 for 1. And his gold per minute should be a little bit higher. Yeah, it is. In fact, it's decently higher. Now remember Convergence, even though you do convert them out, they're still worth a decent chunk of experience as well as gold. So you actually, by doing it, you make more experience on the lane. The only thing you gotta make sure you can do is hold them back and don't lose your conversions. Because if you lose your conversions, then obviously it's a little bit contradictory to what you're trying to achieve on this top lane. But you also want to use them so you can get those last hits to Nyze and not risk your own self. Yamatar's timing, absolutely perfect. Even with 3 conversions, as well as Ken himself trying to right-click down a creep, he's still able to get that denial, and again it happens. And this is just harsh for the Enigma to try and deal with. He's already only got 4 for 4 up against 18 for 6 Morphling. We expect nothing less from Yamatar, though. But Ohio, keeping up with him. In fact, getting in front, just by a little bit. But that's because Darkseer can't do anything. Net's being sacrificed to achieve this. This is the only downside, where you've got Winter, as well as Chen, able to find farm inside the jungle. Net still sits at level 1. The pull is happening from Sharky, so he's finding a couple of levels, but nowhere near the levels that the supports of Orange are getting. And Orange are quite happy to let this go until Ty gets level 6. And maybe they can find the kill off on the Enigma. And then he'll be happy. HY is starting up his own stack. It's just easy souls for him to gather. Get a couple of extra levels up in Shadow Race. And then just come down, and then there's just a burst amount of souls. It's a nice thing to do too, you pop that level 5. Suppose you just want to go straight up to 28 souls. Couple of raises. Max souls. Or max up all your souls. To the point. HY, really not feeling confident to move in at all. It's like he doesn't know where Chen and Tyler are. He's still waiting for the gank, I think. He's waiting for the smoke gank from Chen. Chen's walking around with the smoke, but he hasn't decided to go yet. He's just power leveling inside the jungle. Same with Winter. Continuously pulling, continuously finding farm. And Chen doesn't need to pull. He just goes, oh man. He just needs to stack. But this creep wave is getting all blocked up. It's not going to get out of range in time. Yeah, this one guy here, this guy, or that guy right there, blocking up the camp so he can't stack it. Such a narrow choke line here, and they all just walk over the top of each other. That's why it's better to pull up this direction if you can. But this will be Extinct trying to find some levels. He's also just hoping for a Wilkin to happen. If he can get that Tornado creep, he'll be great, but he's going to use the Satter Blasters instead. Solring build for the Enigma, as expected. It's not a bad thing, the change around a Solring. It's not obviously a great thing for Enigma, but Solring, it's about the same cooldown as your conversions are. The only downside is you can't use it all the time, like for Malifus, if you want to do that, and just keep popping that off. But whenever your conversions run out, you just hit Sol Ring, conversions go again. The timing is almost perfect for it. Anyway, XY coming down for 6-minute room, which he does find. Double damage for him. This stack, still trying to go from HY, but got his timing wrong as well. And now he's starting to bottle up to check out what I assume is the bottom rune. But Sharky needs to plant that ward so they can see it. Now see the double damage rune inside KYXY's bottle now and realize the horrible truth. It's like I walked all that way for nothing. I have to walk all the way back in towards the middle lane. It's just HYHY not having the best game here in mid. Tinker 30 for 16, up against a 23 for 7. It's a good amount of denials coming out from KYXY. Realizing the importance of it. Cannot let that SF get souls.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
So he can max up a 28. She's only 4 away from his max. And now to be soon at his max. And again, now that's going to be a triple stack he's going for. A couple of raises and a right click.
Dire's structures are fortified.
And even pull the creep wave down with it. I don't know if that was 100% intentional, but it works nonetheless. Denies a little bit of the creep wave. Gank on top lane. We're kind of waiting for this one to happen. Centaur with the stun. This will be Ken's death. So we knew that Cheng gank would be coming. It was good timing to go too. It was the same time as the wards were all dying. 6 minutes. And the wards just keel over. So unless you put up new wards, he's got no vision. And with that no vision, he's able to sneak through this little gap here. And then do-do-do-do-do all the way around. And then do-do, and then do-do, and then boom. And remain here. So your tier 1 for a tier 1 tower, as well as first blood. Because goes the way of Orange. Chen's the one that takes the kill. And he's got really good cash, 1700 for him. We're going to see a very early mech out from Extinct. Should be almost, well, not even a 10 minute. At this rate, if they can add more pressure to the tier 2 tower as well, they're going to siege creep there. I'm kind of hearing as a Chen send back. Yeah, it's Ty being sent back to base. Morphling.
Radiant's top tower is under
attack. When waveform just goes a little bit too far. Like extra splash out. Such easy harassment, easy damage with tier 2 towers coming in. No rebuttal from MUFC. So a quick pause out here from Ice. I don't know if they've got a problem with one of their players. We got a funny feeling that this bottom lane's already, this push is over. Chaos Knight and Lashrak, they can keep, to an extent, adding harassment here. But with both Winter as well as Ice on the bottom lane, Ice finally having at least two levels in Iron Shell. The push that comes from MUFC is going to be pretty much stalled. And Orange don't really want to force anything in the middle lane either, because KYXY is getting some free farm here. Also, notice his skill build, not a single point in March and Machines. He knows the push is coming on that top lane, and Dark Tier can repel most of the stuff these days. He knows he has to be that powerhouse when it comes to killing. So it's going to be Laser and Rocket as far as his max abilities go. See if he's able to snipe off any of these heroes like Rubick, Lashrak, Enigma. Three heroes that are pretty easy to bring down. Even SF to a point is easy enough to bring down. But depends how many items he gets in the end. Same with the supports for MUFC, but Orange probably know two of those supports of MUFC. That's what we're talking about before. They're under-farmed. And now Orange are one tower ahead. So they're getting more cash in. Ping's happening. It's because they both ward at exactly the same position. So everybody sees the top. Strike's coming in with sentry wards. So we might be able to get rid of this one. Bright side right now for MUFC is the fact that even though they've lost the tier 1 and the tier 2 tower, they still took one tower in trade. And this Enigma's going to have free control now in the top lane. Won't be difficult at all for him. The only downside is the easy push in, and there's Lashrak going down to level 4. Level 4 on the Rockets. The level 8 Tinker, and that's his BTs. At the same time, Chaos Knight kills the bottom lane. Darkseer going down there. I'm still waiting for Morphling to jump in the middle lane. My bad. But CK as well as SF teaming up for that. It's no ultimate, it was just a couple of raises. Sharky looking to defend the middle lane. Waiting for the creep wave before he let off the Fade Bolt. Get rid of the damage of this creep wave. Even throwing down the ward so he's able to see outside from his trees properly onto the other side. There goes your Fable. So damage goes. CK is coming in too. Going to look for the stun here on KYXY. Actually, no, he's going to go on Chen. 2 second stun. Laser already had me. So, no any trouble for the CK. He just can't hit anything. And Yamata, 3 second stun. There's that strength ball. But look at his mana pool go straight down. He was trying to strength morph as much as he can, but he had nothing left to waveform, nothing left to do anything with. Because that MUMC able to get a very easy pick off on a Morphling, as well as what is probably going to be this end of the tier 1 tower in mid lane. HY is already doing a lot of damage. Maxed up on souls, those right clicks hurt like hell. And you got a couple of conversions helping you out. There's no extra aura stack for HY. At this point, he probably doesn't feel like he needs it. A couple of Tinker illusions coming in, but that's going to be all. Remember too, Tinker's got those BTs. So anywhere on the map he wants to go to, Chen Creep as well, he can go to it. And people like Net have to be very, very cautious when they do stuff like this. So low on life.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Now Darkseer and Yamatar moving towards the bottom lane. Probably expecting HY to come down here and free farm it, which is exactly what he was wanting to do. And then saw the two heroes looking to do it. He's just like, nope, screw that. Let's go creep camp. And building up to Shadow Blade is where he's going to build. It's a different way of building up to it now, where you go the Claymore very early on. Increases your damage, because the other thing is the new Shadow Armlet, which you can do. So you go with the Shadow Blade. Yeah, Shadow Armlet is there. So 1600 gold it costs for that guy. But there's just very little to no purpose for it. Unless you want to go invis for a second. And that'll be it. But the beautiful thing, the beautiful, beautiful thing about the Shadow Blade with SF, it's something which I always love. When you actually pop it, when you pop your ultimate, you won't reveal until the point of the ultimate. You don't come out of your Shadow Blade. It's like Nature's Prophet when he TPs. There is only like maybe half a second between the end cast as well as when the Shadow Blade effect will disappear. And that split second is all you're going to have to stop the ulti. On the bright side though, actually, it could help him out now. It's a nice way to dodge off rockets, when you think about it. Could have helped him to dodge that rocket, as he hasn't brought the damage out to himself yet, and I'm pretty sure he's trying to keep it secret. If he keeps a Shadow Blade secret, then he can all of a sudden just surprise Orange with this huge ass ult in the middle of everybody. Because if he shows it now, then we could look at a gem, we could look at dust, we could look at sentry walls to be prepared for him. But he won't want that. Which is even just buying up normal observer wards, because they are a lot cheaper now. So spend your cash, top lane gank, Net and Ohio. Looking for Yamatar, but Yamatar's a long way gone now. Gonna find nothing, just drop a sentry ward. Observe ward. Won't see much more. It's Orange. What's he been? Has he finished up his mech yet? Thought he would've had that, but he went Arcane Boots first. So give that mana back. It was something we talked about with the Chen changes. Radiant's so difficult now to use all of his abilities. The mana pool, not that high when you don't have your Arcane Boots up. Because he's basically got an extra ability now. It's split it up. These level up the same way with Test of Fate. But one's a pullback, one's a nuke. And both require a certain amount of mana. Nice 4 second stun on the Tinker. And the HY trying to come in close enough, but there's too much damage. Ravish to pop too. And Ohio will go down. And HY trying to retreat away to safety. Which he should be able to do so. Bottled up once, bottled up a second time, waiting for the waveform from Yamata. Which might happen in a moment, but no, he decides not to. Even with no tier 1 tower there. Deciding that the jump was not going to be worth it. They already got the kill on CK. And that's worth it. He now goes 1-1-1. This SF is still getting bigger. Still going to be that big question from him. Top tower has been denied. What's he going to be able to do with that Shadow Blade? Can he really find an opening? And how does MUFC deal with this Tinker who, like, hasn't been delayed at all, BTing in? TP's to a creep. We'll see Ken, who's trying to farm here. And Ken just like, hey guys, yeah, so, pretty sure Tinker, I heard a TP in from him. And then also a rearm. Don't know if people know that as well. Sound is, if you just sit there and you play Dota 2, it's like, oh, I'm just listening to music. If you use your sound, you can hear these kind of things. And there's no vision for the dinosaur. You can see it right there. It's completely blank for them. Enigma walks up to here. Here's the sound effect from this region, and then just retreats back again. There's just no point in sticking around. So he farms a lot safer. Top lane kill. Gonna kill off Well, Darkseer killing over. They might think about Chen as well. There's the waveform from on Sharky, and it should be enough. Extinct will be taking a fall. Bit of pulsing, Hand of God. A little bit of a waste to pop that guy off. There's no way he's going to get away from that, and the support wasn't coming in fast enough. No one else is pretty low, but Chen still feeling that maybe he had a chance to live. Popping the Hand of God. And then HY is able to do some damage to this top. Edict coming off cooldown right now. Hands go up, and Edict is cast. Well, middle lane continues to farm. It's going to be Yamata coming the top lane, but the tower still goes down. There was a TP coming towards that tower as well, which was cancelled. And now Shadowblade and HY is like, come on, man, let's bring down Yamata. He just agi morphed so much. Now he's trying to strength morph it back, but there's that mana going. And he's just above being short. He's got mana boots out from Winter. He was just short, though, of having his waveform for a moment. HY, easy damage. And then the Hand of God. Another reason why he shouldn't have used Hand of God. Sharky gives life back to everybody. Before he loses the ability, he's probably using it. He's like, well, I'm not going to use this during a team fight. I just want to steal it. I can't hold it for 105 seconds. It's going to wear off. Now, maybe a little bit of trouble for Ohio. At the same time, Ice being attacked from below. He's going to surge himself up to try and catch up. But Tinker wants Rock as he's rearming himself up now. So rockets, and that'll be the kill. There's no Phantasm to disjoint it at all. At the same time, check the bottom lane. Double damage rune. And he's looking at Extinct. Three clicks, four clicks is what it's going to take. Use a raise in the midst of all that too. Going to find a Centaur. Tinket's going to TP in. Shadowblade on cooldown for 5 seconds. Trying to bottle to charge himself out of this one. Rubick able to kill off Darkseer in the meantime. And now Shadowblade happens. Can't rock it, can't stop it. And HY will hide inside the Rosh Pit to TP himself out to safety. And they did. They pinged it and they saw it. A nice little snipe off there from HY. Of course, SF, one of his classic heroes. Also killing off the Darkseer in the middle of the lane. He's a long way from home. No tier 1, no tier 2 on top lane. Once again, this is what Orange, in fact, were doing to everybody. Orange successfully did this in the first game for today, where they took out the tier 1, they took out the tier 2 on the enemy jungle. And then they try to control from there, and MUFC pushed them back. This time around, it's the shoes on the other foot. MUFC have the control over the jungle. Trouble for SF, he's got Shadowblade. And they've got nothing to counter him. Sentry wards, now in for Extinct. But he's a long way down. As SF saw him come in, and Sharky's going to defend that tier 1 tower on bot. So important for MUFC to hold this. The longer they hold this, the more secure the farm is for the Enigma. And when you got secure farm for Enigma, you just farm at such an insane rate. Yeah, that Blink Dagger up in no time. He's already got mech. So we got mech, he's building up treads. Just strength treads for now, so he's capable of living during the fights. But once that Blink Dagger and BKB arrive, Orange have nothing that goes through the BKB. Double Tornado starts in the middle lane, but Lashrak's done, cancels one of them. Then the conversions, they want to stop the other one. Malivus done, will also happen from Ken, but you knew that was going to happen with the back. Mech charge already popped, Morphling waves over. Nice black hole, 3 seconds on Yamata, but Winter gets the Ravage off. Net force back past the tower and TP in from Tinker, rockets the laser. Easy damage onto the Lashrak. And Ohio can't do anything more, but at the same time, HY is providing a lot of push power in towards that top tower. So it forces Tinker to TP back to defend, but he won't really care too much. HY still wants to come in. One raise, two raise, a lot of damage still to the Tinker. And the creep wave's gone again. And this will force not just the fact that he's TP back to base, but it'll also force KYXY to remain here for an extra couple of, like, maybe 10 to 20 seconds. But those 10 to 20 seconds, he's got that marksman sheet will do nothing. It's not going to last long enough. But that time is more than enough, and ultimate from HY sniping off the morph in the wall. Man, I apologize for this game. I'm having a horror game as far as seeing kills. No, we need a drink. This one should be easy enough. Smoke and they're going somewhere. All right. Nep, straight in. There's Winter. Edict to start with. Got to get that CK stun. Midnight Pulse already starting off two from the Enigma, bringing Tynander back into it. Nets on low life, but the Meg Charge again back, bringing them in closer is exactly where they wanted to be. And then the pull back in again with the Reality Rift. A wonderful Split Earth by Lashrak. And now they've got a KYXY. They are, however, forced to tank up the Marsh Machines. Buyback happening too. And it's going to be Ohio trying to bring down KYXY. Not going to be possible. Back up towards the higher ground, but Conversion's trying to screw with him a little bit. Not going to happen. Same time, Sharky going to be rocketed to death. So he told you all he needs is a drink. Same time as HYHY pushing that bottom lane. Got to retreat now. But you can overextend so much because of that Shadow Blade. The bonus movement speed as well just lets him run away. It's not even the fact, even if they see him, the bonus movement speed you get out from the Shadow Blade, 20% move faster. That's all you really need. Winter is still here to stop this from happening. He can dust him, but Yamatar can't chase. There's that boot, their speed again. Nobody can keep up with him. The only thing they can hope for is to continuously stun him, but Tide can't give that. You got the slow, which is obviously 40% slow, but then you're adding a bonus 20% to the Shadow Fiend, so it's not the normal slow you'd look for. So he is still able to run, and once that Gush wears off, you lose a lot more. And there's four Sentry Wards coming in. Man, anything they can do to counter the Shadow Blade, they're trying to do it. The problem they're going to have is once they do that, he's going to have his BKB done. HYHY is moving perfectly around the map, finding farm wherever he needs it. And even Sharky's going to let him have one here in the mid. And Sharky's the one building mech up for his team, which means Lashrak building towards his own BKB. And Enigma, well, he built... Wait, what? What? Double mech. TB, bottom lane, 3 second stun going out on top of Winter. Four staff in as well. He is hoping that the rest of MUSC are right behind that. Lashrak slowing down this push with a nice Split Earth, and Fadebot also stopping him. Marsh Machines. It's already happening, but there's nobody there. It's just forcing MUFC to fight past this line. Back behind their towers where they have to do it from. And SF, now he's got BKB. Good timing. Fantastic time for him. Look for the TP. Smack bang here in the middle. If he can do it. If he can do it. He might just walk down or add some pressure towards the other towers. Pick up, drop down. And net, a lot of damage being done. Here comes HYHY. He's TP'd himself in, has gone invis instantly, but Sentry Wards are down, looking for ice, and now BKB and Aldi can start cranking up. He can do it, maybe not. He's losing too much life. He's just standing in the BKB, running from the troll units. And Yamatar is on the retreat. Shadowblade again popping up from HYHY. Malivus down a little bit further down. They're able to pick up the champ. That's Yamatar. He's still the one waiting to see if they can kill him off, but they can't. They don't care about it. They find Chen, they find Tai, they find Darkseer. They find the three non-critical heroes, but they find the three utility heroes instead. And then comes the push. HY, is he really going to take this up in the Marshall Machines as well? I didn't think so. Relying on the mech charge to keep him alive. Tornado stopping off a little bit, four staffing, ice away. And there's double TP already coming in. 2 seconds stun on Tynander might be enough. Four staff can push him in, and Vac pulling him back in again, Ohio. Way too close. And this will now be Orange looking to take the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. Sharky again looking for the defense. Right side for him. Actually, no, he doesn't. He still won't have Hand of God. I don't know why we've got double mech. It could just be he's going to build the headdress and just want the buckler for an easy charge. Winter, nice position for him. Could look for the Ravage. No, he's just out of range now. Sharky has already popped off his hone. It is actually mech. The Force Rockets. Oh, HY. Missed timing. Going to be Gush. BKB to pop. He doesn't want to be slowed because it breaks the effect of the Shadow Blade when he does that. So he's already forced back. And the TP of Tinker wants to stay with this line, goes back, regenerates, comes back for the fight again. If Version's being stolen, but Morphling says thank you very much for the farm and experience. Rockets keep going. And this push that comes out from Orange is so difficult for MUMC to defend it. They can't find a good opening, and this Shadow Blade initiation is not going to be enough, but then again, Enigma with Blink Dagger and a level 2 Black Hole, this should be enough. If they want to find this, they can do so, but only if Orange are going to overextend, which they're not. They're falling back, which means Enigma will have to reveal the existence of this Blink Dagger a little bit earlier than he probably would have planned. The fallback's happening, and yeah, he reveals it on the bottom lane. In the meantime, HY also still finding his farm, but Morphling getting bigger and bigger. 3.3k on him now. Did go and run the defensive build to start with, having that Lincoln Sphere. Which is not the start that he wanted. As far as, like... it's the start that he wanted, but it's not the start which his team probably wanted, which is the damage-dealing build. But maybe this is just Orange saying, "Oh, man!" Wind her up, let her rip, and then run back out again. Dust gonna pop. I don't think he's gonna get himself out of this one. BKB will go. Nate with the movement speed, and there's your Black Hole. Turn around and look at the damage. One raise and keep with the Rykliss going up. 2 seconds on a Winter, pulling back in again. Now KYXY, low on life. Look for the raise, not gonna happen. But what timing for Ken to use that Blink Dagger. Yamatar jumps in. He's looking for HY. Now 2 seconds on him. Sharky, telekinesis off cooldown in 1 second's time. Strength morph is happening. Pick up Yamatar and just hold him there. So HY can go unstoppable. And they pick up the tier 2 tower through the backdoor regen. SF with the last right click. And now up to 3.2k. Horrible fight for Orange. Horrible fight for Orange. An amazing fight for Ken. Killing off the Chendasan with all the heals disappeared for Orange. And then they just held him there, so the right click damage would be enough from HYHY with a couple of raises. And they can even not only take that, but let CK tank it up and he can take Roshan.
Roshan has fallen to the radar.
I don't think anybody really saw that fight coming in the middle lane. Maybe it was the ultimate plan from HYHY. It's like, "Hey guys, I'm gonna completely destroy this Chen. I want you to come in and we'll see what we can get. Plan." HYHY returns to the top lane. He's almost got a full Daedalus. This right click damage is gonna go through the roof for HYHY. The Crystallis and 2.7k. So he can buy the Demon Edge if he wants to. He'll also want to make sure he has enough money in case he needs to buy back that top lane and bottom lane. There's only tier 3 towers left. Is he thinking about going again? I think he is. There's a whole bunch of souls up his sleeve. If he could just catch one person out. In this case, he'll probably catch three out. He's just pushing out that top lane. There's three heroes here. Lashrak copying a little bit of damage as well in the meantime. And whoop, he is going to go down the bottom lane. It's Tinker who finds him. And HYHY, Shadowblading. He's trying to bait out Dust in a random position. Now going to wind up for the ultimate. Wants to bring down Ice and we'll get it too. Even the BKB going to go. HYHY, no wonder he's trying to put the name up like a boss. And then TPing out with the remainder of the BKB, but it doesn't last long enough. Morphling's able to bring him down. March the Machine stuns off, and look at the Centaurs. It's like, I'm ready. There's a stun. And he can't do any more. But then again, he still gets a kill even after death. Remember the rework of SF. The ultimate will expend the remaining soul, half of his remaining souls. Dealing damage. Sometimes you want to die. So he brings down the Tidehunter plus the Darkseer. Orange. I think they're actually the first people, they're the first team that I have actually casted that has died to the SF death. Top lane. A little bit of trouble here for Tinker. Ken does have Black Hole, and now he's gonna pop it. Ice! He just ran straight into it! Phantasm will go, Reality Rift and a lot of damage, but then again, there's the back. They've got to catch up. Is there a stun? Is there a mech? Is there something? There's a 2 second stun on Darkseer, but in comes Winter. He does have Ravage if he needs to pop it, but BKB's already popped off here from Chaos Knight, so one affected. He'll let Ken die. All he really can do. Four stuff down by KYXY. Starts off with the rearm, hopes for rockets, but not going to happen. So he's just going to march the machine and TP out. But Darkseer for the Enigma. And also, Enigma Black Hole going down. Not what they wanted. So even after he respawns, they have to wait another 2 minutes before they'll be able to initiate. I still want to know what they're thinking behind the double mech. It's... double burst heal? Suppose it's not that bad. You can't stack up the auras. Yamatar. And HYHY just having a little bit of fun. It's HYHY wanting to get back up to max souls, which he is now. Just gotta remember too that damage has been stacked up. Change up to the souls as well. SF is the... I think it's the hero that got the biggest buff out of all of the heroes. Having +2 damage per soul. And the presence of the Dark Lord was also raised by 1 for every single level up. Shadow Razor remained the same, and then his Requiem of Souls changed around, as you saw before, dying, and that happens now. Daedalus is there for him. 340 damage is at least a number that will appear. He's going to be in a little bit of trouble. There's a reveal. Hex up instantly, and Nightmare Sedent of HYHY. Ulti again will pop, and a little bit of damage is done, but they mech charge and TP out. Easy gank up on HYHY. Smoking just walking down the top, waiting for someone to overcommit in the lane. And HYHY has been walking around Boulder's Brass wherever he goes. So easy to finish, and now with a gem, I assume. Yeah, gem up on top of the gem on Extinct. They see all. That's the biggest problem with Shadowblade. It now just becomes a crit item, as well as movement speed. Double march the machines, just impossible to fight in that. Enigma still has no black hole as well. 30 seconds he's got before that's back up again. And Orange might keep this onslaught going, but not for longer than 30 seconds. SF will be back, and there's the TP in from Tinker. Feybolt just jumped through them. Nice! Perfect back! Pulling down net. Yamatar able to get the kill. Reaver on Chaos Knight. He just wants to be able to sit there on the front lines and tank it. Hold them back for now. Orange, worst thing they could do right now is think they can keep on going. What was stolen? Adaptive Strike, that's not going to help him. He wants Morph. He wants Strength Morph. So then he can also be a tank. And this could now be the horrible time for Orange. They feel, because it's still 4v5, they can push in. But remember the combination that's going to be able to come out from the Enigma as well as the SF. SF, that's a problem for him though. His ulti is not as powerful. He needs more souls. HYHY has already left that top lane. I think he knew that Orange was going to fall back. Oh, a little bit of delay with the animations. HYHY got to find his max souls again. And that Alderman can do the damage which it has done before in the past. Kills off Extinct pretty easily. Easy soul capture. Already up to 26 out of his possible 36. Well, CK, got to give him the space in the top lane. And he's building up, after building up Reaver, he's gone casual cloak. We know it's going to be a hard he wants. KYXY. Just starting to farm up as far as Ancients go. And then Yamatar is going to steal it all. He's building up towards what could be Mantra or Skadi. But we assume Mantra in this scenario. Able to break the effect. SF. Got to be really cautious about this. There's a lot of heroes in mid. And if Enigma can get that count chat again, then maybe it could be something magical. Especially while Tinker is away. The second Tinker finds the opening, he'll just TP back in again. Point booster? That's unusual. Unless he's gonna build up a Bloodstone. He did go the hunting build, but... K KYXY, he would be involved in a decent amount of it. But doesn't give him... it's just a very unusual item. Like, he'd be looking at Shivas for push. He's already got the Hex, he's already got the BTs. There's no Blink Dagger up at him either, but he just buys the Point Booster instead. As he feels he has a little bit more life to live through. It's definitely not Aghanim's. He can't go Aghanim's. And there's the Blink Dagger coming in for Winter, so key item now for Tidehunter arrives. Sharky, gotta be a little bit cautious. You can see that ward in the high ground. He wants to get rid of it. Gotta be careful! Yeah. Backed up to the high ground. Nice done by Ice, but Forstaff wins all when it comes to positioning. Kalsnar's getting closer and closer towards that heart. Interesting if he actually finishes it first. Nah, yeah, he'll finish it first. If he was going to buy a full hood as well as pipe for his team, he would have done that before he bought the Reaver. HY back up to full souls again. Surprise, surprise. Oh, we look over towards Orange. 2.1k gold up in Chen. Now, he's the one that wants the Aghanim Scepter. Pipe is already done from Darkseer. They got Mech, they got Pipe. Well, now they've also got Smoke to run around in. So they got the Blink Daggers there and the Morphling Replicates on the back of it all too. And he hasn't put up his next item just yet. But they're going to look for an opening. Invis Rune also taken by Tide, and they're going to find Ken. Poor bastard. Smoke being revealed. He's got a Blink! He didn't blink fast enough, and because of it, he goes down. He saw them, then flinched and said, wait, who the hell is that without blinking? Chaos Knight looking for Stranglers, and they're going to find Winter. Reality Rift not going to trigger. And Sharky, well, he saw Anchor Smash. It's not what he wants. Chen, oh, man, nice Centaur Stomp and block off SF. However, oh, man, just two right clicks. Two right clicks, all it takes is 912 critting creeps. He's getting rid of Chen's creeps with every right click. However, don't walk through that wall. Morphling able to get that kill, but HY's on a triple kill now. Finally gets rid of himself. It's like Kamiya Yamata. Hex is there. CK comes in. They've got to get this done on the Morphling. 3 seconds, then right clicking it down. Chaos Knight will end this one. Don't walk back through that wall again. A Shadow Fiend. That damage coming out from him. Darkseer, Chen, Tide. They were nothing! They were absolutely nothing to him! How long is Roshan gonna take? Remember, we've got all of this aura from the negative armor of the presence of the Dark Lord, and he got the bonus attack from the damage from the Necromastery, and he's running a crit on it. 931 crits are coming out from SF, and he gets, 934 crit to get the last hit on Roshan, and now 3.6k. Heart gets finished up on Ohio, and he's just walking through it. He knows he got three clicks and he's gonna kill him. And Extinct, gotta give this guy some confidence. He's had a long way when you got an SF that can run around Invis, even if he does have Gem or not. If SF's in range, he's gone. And we're back. Sorry about that. It's going to be a heart now. That's a satanic. It's a satanic, sorry. Satanic is going to be the build coming out from SF. Sorry about that. Couple of, with the double damage. With the double damage. Oh my lord! Yamata! Trying to straight morph. Maybe HY's overextending this, but there comes the black hole. Double BKB to pop. Ravage will be returned, but it's still not going to be enough. He's trying to bring down HY, but cannot do it. Yamata, he's standing his ground, however, but then again, so does HY. Now we get the last right click in. Gets rid of the illusions and copies of himself. And Isis running down the bot. Who's going to chase him? Blink down, waveform chase, pick up. Telekinesis on cooldown. It's the reason why he can't do it. Nice, gonna TP out, and Sharky wants to walk around. He could just walk straight through and found him. And it's like, oh, wait. No. Thought he was going to juke it, but he just TP'd directly. Some Paul's play coming out from Darkseid to get away from that. And there's your Satanic. So not only is he dealing an insane amount of damage, he's got a large amount of hit points, and he's got the ability to gain back almost his entire life in about, what, two hits? Maybe two hits maximum? They probably end up selling the Shadow Blade as well. Sell that Shadow Blade, buy yourself a Monkey King bar. That's increased the damage up. Doesn't really need the invis anymore. The crit's nice for him and the boomer speed's nice for him. But at this point in the game, it just doesn't offer you as much as a tier 3 item would. Having that Aegis the Immortal up on Chaos Knight. How long has he still got that for? Decent amount of time. HY again looking to that bottom lane. Emmeter is forced to hold more points in strength than what he really wants to. He's at least happy he can finally buy up his Mana Style. We should probably do so right now. Gruy's flying back to base for it. Same time, Nep, as well as Sharky, just looking to ward up nice and deep inside the base. Blink Dagger is up on Sharky now, so he's a good initiator. Then again, so is CK. Nep cops a little bit of damage. Rook has just followed him from when it had originally had vision. Amitar still not wanting to buy up that Mana Style. Must be fearing the need for buyback. Sad thing for him is he can't. Of course, because mana costs more now, doesn't it? No wonder he has to wait a little bit longer. It's the Mana Style recipe. Oh, wait, let's just check that a little bit later on. SF Illusion comes in through the rear. I know it's a fake. The rest of the team is still there. No ability. It wasn't a Hex that was popped. It was just the Illusion timing out. So I haven't revealed the fact that they do have... they have smoked the middle lane. Now they'll reveal the fact. It's already too late. So Tinker TP's out. Goes back to base. Regenerates possibly the smallest mana pool possible. And they're just trying to kill off an Illusion. Is all they end up killing. The real ones on the top lane. TP by Tinker. Be really cautious about this. The reason why a lot of Tinkers prefer to have Blink Daggers, you initially TP in, the Force Start's gonna let him get out from that, but you TP in here, and then you instantly Blink to here, and you're able to get double Marsh Machine off. Lets you push a lot faster and a lot more efficiently. Yamato, gotta be very, very cautious. There's a Blink down already from Enigma. The Lincoln Sphere was triggered, now you're waveform away. Rialnir was attempted there by Ohio, but wasn't fast enough. Waveform just will disjoin it, losing him the vision. And then we go for the tier 3 tower. Fortification already forced. Remember that Blink Black Hole is up. And even as the kill of Yamatar, Blink Ravage is also up. BKB from Lashrak. There's the back in as well. There's your Black Hole holding extinct. Still haven't seen that ulti out from SF. He's holding and just right clicking. Of course, just more damage this way. Taking care of this wall loser because it was stolen. Now Yamatar jumps onto the replicate. He'll jump himself through the wall and then instantly just right click down. Triple kill from HYHY. He didn't stop for anything. I think he moved maybe in this area for that entire fight. Just stood his ground and kept right clicking. And welcome to SF solidly in the metagame. He is a powerful, powerful carry. And it's gonna be tier 3 and double raxing. Gonna go the way of MUFC, so Orange here in the grand final of the ESWC qualifier for the Eastern qualifier. It is gonna be MUFC going 2-0. HYHY being the stand-in for this evening. But what a stand-in he is. So maybe one game away from MUFC qualifying for ESWC. Or maybe Orange can find their form. Find their openings, find everything that's gonna work. Yeah. Wind it up, HY. Wind it up. Wind it up. He's not winding it up. He doesn't care. He's gone. He's DC'd. So that's going to be it. All right, guys. We're going to be back here in a couple of moments' time. We will be returning game number 3, MUMC, going up against Orange.